To get the most out of your HYPROP measurements, the tensiometers must be properly filled with degassed water. Properly degassed tensiometers ensure that you reach the extended measuring range of the tensiometer. Degassing the water can be done using two different methods. The refill unit accessory method is simple and fast. The syringe method takes time and requires more manual labor. Here we'll show the refill unit method. For details on the syringe method, refer to the manual. For degassing, you'll need the following supplies. Put the vacuum pump on the ground where there is a lower temperature to better achieve full vacuum. During the procedure, don't touch the ceramic of the tensio shafts with bare fingers. Grease or soap reduces the hydrophilic characteristics of the ceramic. Connect the tubes of the refill unit as shown. Connect the unit to a timer and the timer to the power outlet. A timer increases the pump life, saves energy, and reduces air bubbles that may be generated when the pump starts. With every degassing procedure, we recommend that you degas an additional bottle of deionized water. Fill holes of the sensor unit with degassed water using the droplet syringe. Place the refilling attachment and clamp it down. Fill the attachment with 23 milliliters of degassed water using the droplet syringe. Attach the HYPROP to the refill unit. Screw up to 4 tensio shafts into the adapters. Put blind plugs on unused connections. Fill the beaker or beakers with degassed, deionized water. Close the valve of the beaker unit. Set the timer to periodically turn the pump on. For example, 5 minutes on and 55 minutes off. Turn the pump on by pressing the power switch. The timer will automatically start the pump and run at the selected intervals. We recommend letting the HYPROP degas for 12 to 24 hours. If the vacuum mount manometer drops rapidly, the system is leaking. See the manual for troubleshooting. To bring the HYPROP back to ambient pressure, turn the pump off. Open the valve slowly, releasing the vacuum slowly. Never remove a tube in order to ventilate the system. The sudden pressure shock will damage the pressure sensors in the sensor unit. When the water in the tensio shafts and the sensor unit has been degassed, you can continue to set up the HYPROP.